The report says that the Hindu population has decreased by around 7.82% between 1950 to 2015. Selection of year is very interesting. Only the Congress phase. Recently, a report has been published by the Prime Minister Economic Advisory Council. उनके पास ये भी होता है, ठीक है? But the way economy is going on, I don't know what they do, but they recommend something. The report says that the Hindu population has decreased by around 7.82% between 1950 to 2015. Selection of year is very interesting. Only the Congress phase. They should have taken 2024 at least. 2024 नहीं तो 21 ही ले लेते कुछ अच्छा दे हैव इंटेंशनली लेफ्ट दिस ईयर आई डोंट नो व्हाइल दैट अ मुस्लिम हैज इंक्रीज्ड बाय ठीक है सजेस्टिंग दैट अ कंड्यूसिव एनवायरनमेंट इन द कंट्री फॉर डाइवर्सिटी सो बेसिकली हिंदू खतरे में है एज वी कैन सी ठीक है द वे पॉपुलेशन इज इंक्रीजिंग द हिंदू इज खतरे में एंड द टाइमिंग ऑफ द रिपोर्ट इज ऑल्सो वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग ठीक है इलेक्शन ईयर्स एंड टू इन्फ्लुएंस द डिस्कोर्स लेट्स सी व्हाट विल हैपन बट नॉनदलेस देयर इज अ प्राइम मिनिस्टर इकोनॉमिक एडवाइजरी काउंसिल फ्रॉम वेयर दिस मॉडल कम पहले तो हमें इसे डिस्कस करना है देखिए दिस इज एन अमेरिकन मॉडल अमेरिका में यू हैव अ प्रेसिडेंशियल डेमोक्रेसी वेयर यू डायरेक्टली चूज योर प्रेसिडेंट एंड यू चूज योर लेजिस्लेचर बोथ आर चोजन सेपरेटली दे आर नॉट डिपेंडेंट ऑन ईच अदर अनलाइक इन इंडिया इंडिया में वट वी डू We choose our MP MLAs who in turn chooses our government. So you choose your MLA and whichever party gets the majority. But remember, Constitution does not talk about party in majority. It simply says anyone who gets the support of the maximum number of MLAs or MP shall become Prime Minister or Chief Minister. So let's say you are a person who have been chosen what we call the independent candidate. Means you are not from any party. But if majority of MLAs, irrespective of their party, supports you, then you can also become Chief Minister or Prime Minister. The Constitution does not talk about party in power. Constitution talk about a person getting majority support. वो बात अलग है कि we have over time evolved party system that whichever party gets the majority gets the government. But remember, Constitution does not talk about this. Constitution simply says anyone who gets the maximum number of people supporting him or her shall become The Prime Minister or the Chief Minister. America में ऐसा कुछ झंझट ही नहीं है because you choose your president directly. That too with the absolute majority. More than 50% of the people vote for one person and that person become president. America में because you choose the head of the state. President is both the head of the state as well as the head of the government. जबकि in parliamentary democracy you have two heads. The head of the government That is the Prime Minister or Chief Minister, the head of the state. That is the President or Governor, whatever is the case. From where we brought this system? Of course, from Britain. So do we need President in India? No. If we speak from genuine point, तो जरूरी नहीं है President का होना. If we want, we can remove President position. It will not bring very significant impact. But because we have adopted the British model, Britain में you have a monarchy. The monarch. Acts like a president of Britain and with nominal powers. They have no powers and from where this come? This come from a glorious revolution. ठीक है तो always remember your polity is nothing but a footnote to European politics. Whatever your constitution, whatever polity you study is nothing more than a footnote to the European politics. All the concepts, ideas, जो भी हम पढ़ते हैं polity में, largely they have evolved in Europe and over time they have been spread around the world through colonialism. When Britishers captured around the world, they did not only bring their administrative setup, they also brought their polity. That's why it is often said that in India, India did not gain freedom. India got transfer of power. India mein freedom nahi mila, hame kya mila hai? Transfer of power from a white sahib to a brown sahib. That's the only difference. Otherwise, look at the language I am speaking, the education we have English based. The civil services you're trying to join, made by Britishers for their purposes. majority of India's legal, up to thoda government has tried to reform by bringing new three codes, Bharatiya Nyaya Sanhita and all, that has been passed, not enforced yet, but passed. IPC, CRPC, CPC, largely whose ideas are this? Britishers. Majority of India's constitution is borrowed from Britishers, basically Government of India Act 1935, made by the Britishers. So basically, we live in a setup made by Britishers, but we have indigenized this. But I call this a smartness. There's no point of inventing the wheel. Wheel has already been invented. We should invent the car from the wheel. So what we have done, we have taken concept from the world and created a polity called Indian Constitution. Clear this much? But nonetheless, sometimes there's a thing called Constitution. There's a thing called reality. Indian Constitution, NVCA, is a parliamentary form of government. In parliamentary form of government, you have a prime minister who enjoys the majority in the house, and he has ministers. Ministers are autonomous people. There's a finance minister should be the prime focal point of all the finances of India. But we have a problem since Atal Bihari Vajpayee's government, because understand, Congress in India is more of a socialist government, believer of socialist ideas. BJP in India is more of a right-wing, आपका कह सकते हैं राइट विंग नेशनलिस्ट गवर्नमेंट. दे बिलीव मोर इन प्रेसिडेंशियल स्टाइल. इसलिए देखिए, सिंस मोदी गवर्नमेंट इज इन पावर, वोट किस पे होता है? मोदी, केजरीवाल, राहुल गांधी. यू डोंट चूज पार्टी, यू चूज प्राइम मिनिस्टर. इलेक्शन ऐसे होते हैं जैसे वी आर चूजिंग प्राइम मिनिस्टर. नन ऑफ अस चूज प्राइम मिनिस्टर, वी ओनली चूज अवर एमपी एंड एमएलए. दे इन टर्न चूज द प्राइम मिनिस्टर, विच एवर पर्सन दे लाइक, जनरली द पार्टी पर्सन. Clear? So understand the difference between the philosophy and the real life practice. This is an example of the presidential form of government. President, American president you choose, aapko pata hoga, all the people who work for American government are known as secretary to the president. As a secretary of state, he's like foreign minister of India. Secretary to state, but whose secretary? President's secretary. So you choose your president in America, and that person appoints everyone. India mein aisa nahi hai. India mein we have two parts. There is a permanent bureaucracy and there is a temporary bureaucracy that you call political bureaucracy. So politicians you choose. Bureaucracy is appointed by president, selected through an exam. This entire setup evolved in Britain. The Britain mein, the permanent bureaucracy of Britain is appointed by the monarch, while the leaders who command bureaucracy. To understand, the real power as per the constitution lies with the president of India. If anyone asks you this question, who is the top executive head in India? It is president. All the powers under the constitution lies with president, but he cannot use those power without the recommendation of prime minister. So legally speaking, prime minister does not do anything. अगर आपने, हैव यू एवर सीन एनी गवर्नमेंट नोटिफिकेशन, एनी गवर्नमेंट पॉलिसी, एनी गवर्नमेंट ऑर्डर, उस पर साइन किसके होते हैं? सेक्रेटरी. सेक्रेटरी टू हूम? प्रेसिडेंट. चीफ मिनिस्टर, होम मिनिस्टर, डिफेंस मिनिस्टर, दे साइन नो डॉक्यूमेंट्स. ऑल डॉक्यूमेंट्स आर साइंड बाय द सेक्रेटरी हु इज अपॉइंटेड बाय द प्रेसिडेंट, बिकॉज कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन सेज ऑल द एग्जीक्यूटिव पावर शैल बी विद द President, who shall exercise that power by either by himself or by an officer subordinate to him. So who appoints IAS officers? President. So you people work at the pleasure of president. So you, when you sign a document, you are signing that document on behalf of president. Clear this much? So this system was in US. Because US mein everyone is like an advisor to the president. That's why it is, dekhi kya, Economic Advisory Council. So this is a British system. Same, National Security Advisor. Again US system. Because US mein everyone is an advisor to the president. India mein you have a prime minister and he has a defense minister. Defense minister shall take over entire security apparatus. But India mein kya hai? There's a position called National Security Advisor, who acts like a focal point of defense of India. Jabki aapke paas defense minister bhi hai. So that is a blame that is being said. India is now governed in a prime ministerial form of government. India is no longer a parliamentarian form of government. India is a prime ministerial form of government, where prime minister has appointed advisory council, National Security Council, headed by National Security Advisor, appointed by the president on the recommendation of prime minister, not accountable to the people. That is an executive head, not accountable to anyone. Defense minister is accountable to you. And right now, understand, national security advisor is the most powerful bureaucrat in India. He is a cabinet rank position. Matlab, he is equal to defense minister. Aisa kabhi nahi hota. Generally, defense minister is a representative of the people. He shall be the chief of defense. But who is the chief of defense right now? National security advisor. Your agencies like RAW, External Spy Agency, IB, Intelligence Bureau, Internal Spy Agency, Military Defense, Chief of Military Advisor, everyone reports to whom? Not to Defense Minister, but to National Security Advisor, who directly reports to Prime Minister. Clear? So this is a US model. Then why we are criticizing this? Because US may there is a check and balance. President is elected, and President appoint everyone as a secretary. All people President appoint are approved by the legislature. Senate hearings, we call this. You may have seen in movies also. Spider-Man, Batman movies, mein aapne dekha hoga. For example, Iron Man movie, mein, Iron Man is sitting and he's giving some speech to people sitting in the dais. That is called Senate. The upper house of US legislature is known as Senate. Hamara hota hai Rajya Sabha. So all the appointment made by the president are approved by the Senate of US Congress. You can say all the appointment made by the prime minister in India shall be verified by the Rajya Sabha. But this is the problem. We have adopted US model without US safeguards. Yahan pe president can appoint anyone and they are not accountable to people. Nobody knows who is NSA, why they are appointed. America mein everyone knows why anyone is appointed, because president appoints them. They are verified by the Senate in an open hearing. Open hearing mein they ask question, it brings accountability basically. Clear? India does not have this. So this Prime Minister Advisory Council is an example of American political system. Clear? This is the criticism of this council. It should not be Prime Minister Economic Advisory Council, because hamare paas already Finance Minister hai. To uska kaam kya bacha? If everything is to be with the Prime Minister, then what is the point of Finance Minister? Hata do se, Nirmala Tai ko hatao. Baat samajh mein aayi? So it should be rather than Economic Advisory Council to Finance Minister, not to Prime Minister, because we are a parliamentary democracy, not a prime ministerial democracy. So please understand, Indian Constitution talks about parliamentary democracy. In real life, we have a prime ministerial democracy. Clear? So jaldi se dekhte hain, what is this? As you can see, it is non-constitutional. There is no law for National Security Advisor. There is no law for Economic Advisory Council. They all function outside of the constitution, basically directly reporting to the prime minister himself or herself, whatever may be the case. In theory, it is an independent body which will advise the prime minister on economy related issue, and I don't know what they do, because as far as we know economy, that's very bad going on. So pata nahi wo advice kya karte hain, but nonetheless they have published the report. So clear hai, what is this EAC? It's Economic Advisory Council to the Prime Minister. It is a basically American model of appointing bureaucrats directly answering to the head of the government. America mein both head of the government and the head of the state is the same person, the president of America. India mein both are different. The head of the state is president appointing IAS officer to work on his behalf, and the head of the government is prime minister appointing ministers to command the bureaucrats. All the bureaucrats are commanded by concerned ministers appointed by president on the advice of prime minister. And who shall be the prime minister? Anyone, irrespective of party, who enjoy majority support in legislature. Clear? There is no executive power with the prime minister except recommending to the president in theory. But Supreme Court has numerous times given judgment and said, for example, Indira Gandhi judgment or Ram Javaya case, Supreme Court has made it very clear, even though constitution says all the executive power are vested in the president, but the president cannot exercise those power without the recommendation of prime minister. In legal principle, all the powers of executive are with president, but in reality, those power are exercised on the advice of prime minister. So real life, legally speaking, prime minister has no powers. But in real life, all the powers lies with Prime Minister. Basically, ऐसे समझे, you have a gun, but you cannot use a gun without my recommendations. That's it. ठीक है? नहीं, प्रेसिडेंट ही अपॉइंट करता, प्राइम मिनिस्टर कुछ नहीं कर सकता, वो साइन नहीं कर सकता, अपॉइंटमेंट दूर की बात है, वो सब कुछ प्रेसिडेंट करता है, वो बस रिकमेंड करता है प्रेसिडेंट को, ही जस्ट रिकमेंड टू द प्रेसिडेंट, अपॉइंट दैट ड्रामा, बट एवरी अपॉइंटमेंट इज डन बाय प्रेसिडेंट ओनली और ऑफिसर सबॉर्डिनेट टू द प्रेसिडेंट ऑथराइज बाय द प्रेसिडेंट. जैसे यू अपॉइंट फॉर एग्जाम्पल योर ऑफिस क्लर्क, एज एन आईएएस ऑफिसर यू अपॉइंट अ ऑफिस क्लर्क, तो ये माना जाएगा दैट ऑफिस क्लर्क हैज बीन अपॉइंटेड बाय द प्रेसिडेंट इनडायरेक्टली. क्लियर? सब कुछ प्रेसिडेंट करता है. एनीवे, तो प्लीज रिमेंबर दे ईएसी पब्लिश टू पीरियोडिक रिपोर्ट, एनुअल इकोनॉमिक आउटलुक एंड द रिव्यू ऑफ द इकोनॉमी. सो दीज आर टू रिपोर्ट्स व्हिच आर पब्लिश्ड बाय द इकोनॉमिक एडवाइजरी काउंसिल. नाउ दे हैव कंडक्टेड दिस स्टडी एंड नाउ वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज दिस स्टडी सेज, देन वी विल अंडरस्टैंड वेरियस डायमेंशंस, पॉलिटिकल एंगल एज वेल. The share of religious minorities across country analysis. The framework of year is 1952-2015. According to the report, the majority religion has, that is Hinduism, has seen a decline of 7.82, roughly yaad rakhna, around 8%. Roughly remember, around 8%. However, this report also highlights this is in sync with the global trend. Because around the globe, the majority population is declining vis-a-vis minority population. The logic is why. वो हम थोड़ी देर में समझेंगे. पहले देख लेते हैं ये बोल क्या रही है. ठीक है? If you can see, around the world, the majority population have increased in respective countries by an amount about 22%. तो इसका मतलब, India is showing the same trend. India is not showing a different trend. It is showing the same trend as we see in the world. Why is it happening? We will understand in a bit. Next, the share of Jain population has decreased from. So Jain population has decreased in India. Next, Muslim population has increased around 43%. So Muslim population since 1950 has increased. Hindu population has decreased. Jain population has decreased. Christian population has also increased to around 5%. Sikh population has increased to around 6.5%. Parsi's population has seen the largest decline from 0.032. Matlab Parsis are like morality. They are about to be extinct. Theek hai? So that morality is about to be extinct. Parsi aapko pata hoga. Parsis are the people who came from Iran. Iran used to be a Zoroastrian, bolte hain ise. Zoroastrian, it's a proper religion. Then Islam came into Iran, it uprooted the Parsis, they ran toward India. So that's how you get Parsis in India. It's the indigenized words of Zoroastrian. It comes from Persia. Parsi, Persia, Iran. Basically, these were the people of Iran who came to India. Okay, so they are about to go extinct. Ab let's see how India has behaved vis-a-vis its neighbor. अगर आप नेबर कंपोजिशन देखेंगे तो एक्सेप्ट फॉर म्यांमार, इंडिया एंड नेपाल एंड मालदीव्स, एवरीवेयर एल्स मेजॉरिटी पॉपुलेशन हैज इंक्रीज्ड एज अ परसेंटेज. इंडिया एंड इट्स नेबरहुड में द इंडिया नेपाल बोथ हिंदू नेशंस, मतलब मेजॉरिटी हिंदू, मालदीव्स मेजॉरिटी मुस्लिम, म्यांमार मेजॉरिटी बुद्धिस्ट. ओनली दीज थ्री नेशंस हैव सीन डिक्लाइन इन majority population by various amount. Baki jitne desh hai, Afghanistan, Pakistan, Bangladesh, Sri Lanka and Bhutan, mean two Buddhist country, three Muslim country, they have seen an increase in basically majority population. Ab we have to understand the reasons ki ye sab drama hua to kyon hua. Dekhiye isme ek cheez notice kijiye, largest increase of majority population is in Bangladesh. And if you have studied international relation, तो वहाँ पे हम एक चीज़ करते हैं, जिसे बोलते हैं demographic invasion from Bangladesh. That is also one of the biggest reason for Assam Accord, one of the biggest reason for Citizenship Amendment Act. We have discussed that earlier also. एक बार थोड़ा reference देखेंगे. Now let us see the main critical analysis. Is Hindu really in danger? As the political narrative is that देर लॉट ऑफ पीपल हु गिव रेडिकल स्टेटमेंट, जैसे यति नरसिंहन जो भी नाम है इस व्यक्ति का, एक्सट्रीमली पेट्रियार्क रेडिकल एंड मिसोजिनिस्ट. ही हैज गिवन अ वेरी सिंपल स्टेटमेंट दैट हिंदू शैल प्रोड्यूस मोर बेबीज अदरवाइज द मुस्लिम विल सब्स्टिट्यूट हिंदूज इन इंडिया एंड इंडिया विल बिकम अ शरिया लैंड बेसिकली. एंड देर लॉट ऑफ पीपल हु सेज द सेम थिंग पर्टिकुलरली इन दिस धर्म संसद. दे ऑर्गेनाइज समथिंग वी कॉल धर्म संसद और द रिलीजियस कॉन्ग्रीगेशन. दे डिस्कस दिस काइंड ऑफ ड्रामास. सो Pew research, Pew conducted a research and they found that there are the three factors. Any change in population has only three factors: fertility rate, migration and convergence. That's how the population change happens. Let's see. First, according to Census of India, you know, Indian government conducts census every 10 years. That's a constitutional. The growth rate of Muslim has been declining from 32 to तो ग्रोथ रेट जो मुस्लिम पॉपुलेशन में देखिए, इफ यू लुक फ्रॉम 1950 टू 2015 इट हैज इंक्रीज्ड मोर देन 40%. बट इफ यू लुक देयर पॉपुलेशन रेट ऑफ इंक्रीज इट हैज डिक्लाइन. व्हाइल हिंदू ग्रोथ रेट हैज फॉलन फ्रॉम मींस डिक्लाइन इन मुस्लिम ग्रोथ रेट इज मोर देन डिक्लाइन इन हिंदू ग्रोथ रेट. तो मुस्लिम पॉपुलेशन इंक्रीज हैज डिक्लाइंड बाय 8.3% जबकि हिंदू पॉपुलेशन ग्रोथ रेट हैज डिक्लाइंड बाय 6%. ठीक है, यहां तक पहला पॉइंट समझ में आया. नेक्स्ट, अकॉर्डिंग टू नेशनल फैमिली हेल्थ सर्वे, दीज ऑल आर गवर्नमेंट डेटा, टोटल फर्टिलिटी रेट. व्हाट इज टोटल फर्टिलिटी रेट? नी बार पढ़ा है हमने क्या? टोटल फर्टिलिटी रेट मींस the number of babies a young woman in her productive life, that is from menarche to menopause, is likely to give birth to. What is total fertility? The number of young ones born to a productive woman in her entire productive life, from menarche to menopause basically. Total fertility rate according to NFHS data has declined around all groups. Har group mein decline hua hai, and for Hindu woman the drop is around 1.4, but for Muslim women it is around. So both these data says one thing. Pehla, the growth of Muslim population has declined with more than Hindus. Second data, that total fertility rate among Muslim women have declined more than Hindus. Why? Because the prime factor is there is only one state in India which has more women than men, Kerala. Why? Because Kerala has 100% primary education. Primary education is 100%. Every single children in Kerala goes to school. Only state in India. And we have seen this multiple times. That if you really want to reduce what? Total fertility. You have to give more education to the woman particular. For example, Bihar. Bihar has 3 point something. Highest fertility rate in entire India. Reason? The woman education rate there is less than 60. I think 61, 62 ke aaspaas hai. It's very low. So Bihar mein the woman education rate is very low. And it leads to direct. Seedha sa logic hai. If a woman get married earlier. Earlier marriage means early babies. Early babies means more babies. Or with less education, you cannot avail better contraceptives. Jaise the best contraceptives available is copper टी. शायद आपने नाम सुना होगा कभी इसका. इज द बेस्ट वन. कॉपर टी इज प्लांटेड इन व्हाट यू कॉल यूट्रस एंड वजाइना के बीच में. यू हैव समथिंग वी कॉल सर्विक्स. इट इज प्लांटेड इन द सर्विक्स एंड इट प्रिवेंट्स एनी काइंड ऑफ फर्टिलिटीज ऑफ एग. इट्स हाईली प्रोडक्टिव, बेटर देन कॉन्डम्स. कॉन्डम्स आपको पता होगा दे आर अराउंड 99% इफेक्टिव. देयर इज नो गारंटी इन स्पाइट ऑफ कॉन्डम द वुमन विल नॉट गेट प्रेग्नेंट, बट इन कॉपर टी इट इज मच बेटर, मच सेफ एंड इट इज it gives productivity, I would say protection for around years. Ek baar plant karo and for years you are done. But ye batayega kaun? Education. Aur jab education hi kam hai to fir kaise pata lagega? Baat samajh mein aayi? So it is the most safe contraceptive, but the problem here is that lack of education particularly among women is leading to no use of contraceptive. First thing. Second thing, less education matlab you will get married earlier. If you have more education, you will stay out of productive force. For example, 30-31 mein you may get married. For example, the average age for a woman to get married is around 30, literate one. इलिटरेट वन इज वेरी अर्ली 18-19. कितना फर्क है, 10 साल का फर्क आता है. दैट्स वाई बिहार हैज अ वेरी हाई टोटल फर्टिलिटी, जबकि अदर स्टेट पर्टिकुलरली केरला हैज लेस देन 2, विच इज ऑल्सो डेंजरस बाय द वे. वट इज द ऑप्टिमम फर्टिलिटी रेट? 2.1 means two pairs shall give birth to two kids plus 0.1 to ensure that the population shall always remain young. On an average the it should be. इस वक्त इंडिया का कितना है? So we are less than what we should have. India में total fertility rate on an average of entire India is 2.08. It is less than 2.1. मतलब our population is shrinking over time. The problem is not with respect to more babies. जैसे हम बोलते हैं ना, we need population law in India. That's a wrong myth. हमें population law की जरूरत नहीं है. We need to increase TFR in some state and decrease TFR in other states. बिहार में वी नीड टू डिक्रीज TFR, केरला में वी नीड टू इंक्रीज TFR, बिकॉज केरला इज गेटिंग एजेड वेरी सून. जैसे जापान, आपको पता होगा जापान इज हाईली एज्ड. अभी रिपोर्ट आई है मोर देन 20 लाख समथिंग हाउसेज इन जापान आर एम्प्टी, बने हुए हैं, खाली पड़े हैं. हु बाइज न्यू हाउसेज? द यंग पॉपुलेशन. यू डू न्यू जॉब्स, यू बाय न्यू हाउसेज. ओल्ड पीपल हैव सेम हाउस, अब वो थक चुके हैं जिंदगी से, दे नॉट वेरी इंटरेस्टेड इन गोइंग एडवेंचरस. बात समझ में आया? So we need how much total fertility rate? 2.1. What is our status right now? It is less than desire. So it should, we have to increase TFR in India rather than decrease TFR. But we need to increase in some state and decrease in other states. Clear this much? So first thing that we understood, that Muslim population growth rate in India has declined more than Hindus. Second point, TFR among Muslim women has declined more than Hindus. Simple reason, because education among Muslims women is less than Hindu women. So maan lete hain, if you provide education to Hindu women, to kya hoga? Marginal increase hoga. Muslim mein large increase hoga. Baat samajh mein aaya? Jaise for example, UPSC mein going from 1 mark to 80 marks is easy part. Going from 80 to 81 take extra efforts. As you go up the upper age, even single marks takes extraordinary efforts. Going from 1 to 80 is easy. 80 to 90 takes entire life. ठीक है? जैसे हमने example दिया था, Muslim woman, देखिए केरला में क्या है? 2.25, जबकि आपका बिहार में क्या है? So Hindu women in Bihar are producing more babies than Muslim women in Kerala. Why? Education. Education is the best mechanism for woman empowerment, nothing else. That's why it is often said that you should educate your girl more than your boys. Aisa bola jata hai, ab you give education to a boy, you give to a person. You give education to a woman, you educate entire generation. Because an educated woman will make sure that the babies are also equally educated. Males to enjoyment mein lage hain apni zindagi ke. Anyway, jokes aside, clear hai? A Business Standard published an analysis of this report. Why this report appears very biased and it is trying to shape a narrative. Why? You have talked about what? Percentage rather than absolute increase. Percentage or absolute mein farak hota hai. Literal farak hota hai. Let's take an example. Abhi humne kya samjha? That Muslim population, Hindu population has declined by around, while Muslim population has increased more than 43%. Clear? Ab ise dekhte hain. Hindus population was 320 million, matlab 32 crores in 1950. Ab kitni hai? Iska matlab we have added 5 times. Hindus have grown 5 times since 1950, jabki Muslims have grown for every Muslim. Matlab for every single Muslim added to the population in these years, how many Hindus have been added? 5. That's the difference between percentage and absolute numbers. Percentage mein total composition hota hai. Absolute numbers mein you can see the real change. The real change is from 320 to 1 billion. It means Hindus have increased 5 times more than Muslim. But agar percentage wise dekhoge, to Hindus have declined by 8. लास्ट पॉइंट देखते देन वी विल कंक्लूड. द फास्टेस्ट ग्रोइंग रिलीजन इन इंडिया इज विच हैज इंक्रीज्ड 1600%. सो बेसिकली व्हाट इज द कंक्लूजन? द कंक्लूजन इज हिंदू खतरे में है, नहीं हो ही नहीं सकता. रीजन बीइंग वी हैव ग्रोन 5 times द मुस्लिम पॉपुलेशन, बट एज अ पार्ट ऑफ एंटायर कंपोजिशन मुस्लिम हैव ग्रोन 40%, जबकि हिंदूज हैव ग्रोन ओनली, सॉरी हिंदू हैज रिड्यूस बाय. क्लियर समझ में आया सबको? सो हिंदू खतरे में है नैरेटिव इज नॉट राइट, बिकॉज हिंदूज पॉपुलेशन हैज ग्रोन 5 times द मुस्लिम पॉपुलेशन इन द पास्ट, जो भी ईयर का एनालिसिस इन्होंने करा है एब्सोल्यूट नंबर्स में, बट परसेंटेज वाइज इट मे अपीयर्स अ डिक्लाइन. अब क्वेश्चन आता है, कैन मुस्लिम सब्स्टिट्यूट हिंदू एनी टाइम? नेवर, हो ही नहीं पाएगा, बिकॉज देयर इज समथिंग वी कॉल लिमिटेशन ऑफ रिसोर्सेस. इंडिया इज ऑलरेडी ओवर क्राउडेड. अगर आपको पता हो, इंडिया वी हैव अराउंड 2.4% ऑफ वर्ल्ड लैंड मास एंड इट सपोर्ट्स 18% ऑफ वर्ल्ड पॉपुलेशन. तो वी, आपको पता होगा, वी आर नाउ द लार्जेस्ट कंट्री इन टर्म्स ऑफ पॉपुलेशन. वी हैव सरपास चाइना, आई थिंक प्रीवियस ईयर सरपास किया हमने. सो वी आर ऑलरेडी ओवर क्राउडेड. इस चीज का कुछ लोग होते हैं जो वेल्ले होते हैं, सर्वे करते रहते हैं, ठीक है, उससे हमें पता लगा. इंडिया आई थिंक वी आर अराउंड 140 billion समथिंग, 140 crore समथिंग. एनीवे, पॉइंट हियर इज दैट आवर पॉपुलेशन हैज इंक्रीज्ड एट अ वेरी रैपिड पेस. हमें क्या करना है? ओल्ड लोगों को जल्दी टपकाना है और यंग लोगों को ज्यादा पैदा करना है. बेसिक लॉजिक हियर इज, मैं टपकाना ये नहीं बोल रहा, ना मार दो. द लॉजिक हियर इज बिकॉज हु इज द प्रोडक्टिव फोर्स विच टेक्स द कंट्री फॉरवर्ड? द यंग वन, क्योंकि वो ही काम करते हैं. The younger one, less than 14 kids, they are not productive. The upper than 55 are also not productive. The age between 15 to 55 is the productive age, the working population. India is right now very young. We are very fortunate. India mein jo median age hai, wo kya hai? 7 and 29 hai. 9 hai mere khayal mein. Median age matlab 50% of Indians are less than 29 years. So we are a very young force. और ये young force क्या कर रही है? Instagram पे reel बना रही है. Angel Priya के account बना रही है ये young force. That is what you call demographic dividend. If we don't give employment to this force, what will happen? They will get old one day. अभी आपके पास बहुत young population है. This youngers will get old. If they don't have a job, they will not save money. Then when they will get old, who will provide them health care? Sarkar. Understand, if you don't invest in education, health and employment today, the government will bear them tomorrow. Karna hi padega. And who will pay for this? Your grandchildren. Theek hai, to wo jada bole to unhe bol do, tumhe hame jhelna padega. बात समझ आए? तो दिस इज द रीजन वी नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड. डेमोग्राफिक डिविडेंड दैट वी हैव टुडे कैन कन्वर्ट इनटू डेमोग्राफिक इको. वी कॉल दिस डेमोग्राफिक डिविडेंड एंड डेमोग्राफिक इको. द यंग फोर्स दैट यू हैव टुडे, इफ वी डू नॉट गिव देम प्रॉपर एम्प्लॉयमेंट, प्रॉपर अपॉर्चुनिटीज, दे विल कन्वर्ट, दे विल गेट ओल्ड वन डे एंड देन दे विल बी अ बर्डन ऑन द इकोनॉमी एंड देन यू हैव टू टेक केयर. अभी उन्हें जॉब दे दोगे तो क्या करेंगे? दे विल सेव मनी फॉर देमसेल्फ, देयर ओल्ड एज पेंशन प्रोग्राम्स. So when they will get old, they will take care of themselves. आपको टेंशन नहीं है. But if you don't give them job, job का मेरा मतलब यहाँ पे नहीं पकोड़ा बेको. There are two kind of job. One is we call formal, one we call informal. Formal job मतलब a job that gives you money with social security. You are earning 1 lakh rupees is not important. What is your purchasing power is important. If you are earning 1 lakh rupees and your expenditure is 80,000, तो actual में what you are earning? 20,000. जॉब है लोगों के पास. क्वेश्चन ये नहीं है कि पीपल डोंट हैव अ जॉब. द क्वेश्चन इज इट अ गुड जॉब? एंड वी हैव डिस्कस मल्टीपल टाइम्स, प्रीवियस भी हमने करा था ILO की रिपोर्ट. मेजॉरिटी ऑफ जॉब्स इन इंडिया आर नॉट गुड जॉब्स. यू आर वर्किंग, यू आर गेटिंग 40,000, बट योर एक्सपेंडिचर इज 33,000. डिस्पोजेबल इनकम यू डोंट हैव. एंड इफ यू डोंट हैव डिस्पोजेबल इनकम, हाउ वुड यू सेव? And if you will not save, then who will bear your social security when you will get old? Sarkar. Marne nahi de sakte, democracy hai. Baat samajh mein aaya? So this is the concern. इट शुड बी द फोकस पॉइंट. लेकिन फोकस पॉइंट क्या है? हिंदू खतरे में. सो वट वी हैव कंक्लूडेड फ्रॉम दिस स्टडी, फ्यू थिंग्स. पहला, हिंदू खतरे में नहीं है, हो भी नहीं सकता, बिकॉज देयर इज अ लिमिटेशन ऑफ नेचुरल रिसोर्सेज. इंडिया इज ऑलरेडी ओवर क्राउडेड. दिस ओवर क्राउडिंग इज डिक्रीजिंग बिकॉज इंडियाज टोटल फर्टिलिटी रेट राइट नाउ इज 2.08. इट इज लेस देन वट वी वॉन्ट, बट सम स्टेट हैज मोर प्रोडक्टिविटी देन सम स्टेट. तो केरला में वी नीड टू इंक्रीज TFR, बिहार में वी नीड टू डिक्रीज TFR. प्लस the youth, we have around 50% of young population, 65% of Indians are less than 35. Inko hume kya dena hai? Education, skills, health and employment. These should be the focus. Yes, of course, Aditi, we can, dekhiye, I'm not saying government jobs. It's a fact, government cannot give job to everyone. What we are saying is better jobs. प्राइवेट में ही सही, बेटर जॉब्स, अ जॉब दैट प्रोवाइड पेंशन, दैट प्रोवाइड सोशल सिक्योरिटी. सो व्हेन द दैट जर्नलिस्ट आस्क्ड मोदी जी दैट यू आर ब्लेम फॉर अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट, ही सेड इफ समबडी सेलिंग पकोड़ा आउटसाइड योर ऑफिस वुड यू कॉल दैट एम्प्लॉयमेंट, द आंसर शुड बी येस सर, बट इज इट अ डिजायरेबल एम्प्लॉयमेंट? नो. कैन दैट पर्सन सेव सफिशियंट सो दैट हिज चिल्ड्रन कैन गेट बेटर एजुकेशन? नो, बिकॉज राइट नाउ इंडिया में वी आर प्राइवेटाइजिंग एवरीथिंग. And that is the reason you are preparing for government jobs. क्योंकि कम हो गई हैं. 15 lakh applicant previous year. It's very high. UPSC में किसी जमाने में 60,000 होते थे. Why? देखिए सीधी सी बात है. If you get, for example, you just got graduated, you got employment in railways, मान लेते हैं. तो you neither will have a time nor energy to prepare for civil service. But because you don't have a job which you believe is good, so what do you think? I am preparing anyway, let's follow my dream. So you start preparing for civil services. That's a 15 lakh applicant. It is very high and it is increasing every year because every year unemployment is a severe point of pain. Clear? Hai? So this should be our focus rather than this drama of whose population is more. Clear? Ab question ye hai, if Hindus are not in khatre mein, then why it is a narrative? Why the people believe this? इसके लिए थोड़ा सा हमें समझना पड़ेगा थॉमस खुन को. थॉमस खुन, ही रोट अ वर्क नोन एज स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ साइंटिफिक रिवोल्यूशंस. इन दैट ही कॉइंड दिस आइडिया, व्हाट वी कॉल दिस पैराडिम, डी जी साइलेंट पैराडिम. बट इस पैराडिम अकॉर्डिंग टू हिम देर आर नंबर ऑफ आइडियाज, लेट्स से एक्स वाई जेड आइडियाज. दीज आइडियाज आर फ्लोटेड इन टू द इकोनॉमी और फ्लोटेड इन टू द सोसाइटी. ओवर टाइम क्या होता है, आउट ऑफ दीज थ्री आइडिया one idea will become predominant over these ideas, will die over time, and this idea will become common sense. Jab bhi aap, for example, you, when you call say somebody this person is bad, jab aap kisi ko bad bolte ho to you must have a reference of a good guy in your mind. Agar aapke paas reference point nahi hai to bad kaise ho gaya? You have a reference in your subconscious mind, you have a reference what a good person looks like. Then you judge other person as bad person. That reference point is called paradigm. So over time kya hota hai, some values acquire the status of paradigm. Aur ye kaise hota hai, this is what Paul Brass has said, something he called politically induced social change. Politically induced social change. पॉलिटिक्स क्या करती है, आउट ऑफ वेरियस वैल्यूज इट पिक सम वैल्यूज, देन इट प्रोपोगेट दोज वैल्यूज अगेन अगेन एंड अगेन. जैसे फॉर एग्जांपल, मिनिस्टर ऑफ प्रोपेगेंडा अपॉइंटेड बाय हिटलर, ही इज नॉट अ गुड पर्सन टू कोट, बट ही सेड वन थिंग राइट, से वन लाई 1,000 टाइम्स इट बिकम्स ट्रुथ. रिपीटिशन क्रिएट्स रियलिटी. व्हेन यू, जैसे फॉर एग्जांपल आपने देखो कई बार यू रिमेंबर कंसेप्ट बट अब भूल जाते हो पढ़ा कहाँ था. यू यार पढ़ा तो है, आई नो दिस आइडिया, बट आई एम फॉरगेटिंग वेयर आई हैव स्टडीड दिस. सो क्या होगा, आई विल टेल यू अ लाई टुडे, टुमोरो आई विल डू द सेम, द डे आफ्टर टुमोरो आई विल डू द सेम. ओवर टाइम यू विल फॉरगेट मी एज द सोर्स, यू विल रिमेंबर द आइडिया ओनली. दैट्स हाउ कॉमन सेंस आर क्रिएटेड. एंड आई ऑलवेज टोल्ड यू रियलिटी इज नथिंग बट अ पैराडिम. यू बिलीव इट, दैट्स व्हाई इट इज ट्रू. Even in science, it applies according to him. For example, आपको पता होगा न्यूटन्स लॉ ऑफ ग्रेविटेशन, विच वी कॉल यूनिवर्सल लॉ ऑफ ग्रेविटेशन, दैट एवरी बॉडी अट्रैक्ट अदर बॉडी इन दिस यूनिवर्स बाय अ फैक्टर ऑफ जी एम एम बाय आर स्क्वायर. नॉट इंपॉर्टेंट टू रिमेंबर फॉर्मूला. By this formula, they everybody attract. Basically, you cannot lift a finger without disturbing this entire universe. So, when you party, you have destroyed this universe. That's what Newton's law. But Newton's law fail. कहाँ fail होता है? जबकि हम इसे क्या बोलते हैं? Universal. हर school book में आपने पढ़ा होगा. Universal है ये. This law fails in case of Mercury. Mercury is a very small planet near the sun. If you apply Newton's law, the Mercury over time should dissolve into sun, but aisa kabhi nahi hua. Then comes Einstein, and Einstein gave theory of general relativity. That theory he gave 100 years ago. Isse humne 2015 mein prove kara hai. That's why he was known as a visionary. What he said 100 years ago, humein kya lag gaya? 100 saal lag gaya ye sabit karne mein. Einstein sahi bol raha tha. Because understand this entire, जैसे हमारे बीच में what is has been spread, love के अलावा हमारे बीच में क्या spread है? You think that this space is empty? No, it's a four-dimensional fabric. जैसे paper देखा है आपने? Paper जो होता है, paper में if for example if I do something on one side, it creates a ripple that goes. Just for example, the surface of water, you put a stone, it creates ripple. So actually, this entire world is a four-dimensional fabric. It is not visible from our eyes because we can see only three dimensions: length, breadth, and height. We cannot see time. There's some organism on this on this universe that can see 5 to 6 dimensions. Discover? Yes, discovery mein check karna. Okay, there's some organism which can see up to 6 dimensions. Hum kitni dekh sakte hain? Sirf 3. That's why we cannot see this dimension which is in between us. इसको हमने कब प्रूफ किया? 2015 में. This is what we call gravitational waves. When a star explode, contract, everything moves. तो actually क्या है? If you look at this thing, this entire universe is like a fabric. Sun यहाँ पे बीच में है. Example. तो when you have a paper, you put a heavy object. तो उसमें क्या आ जाता है? एक depression. That is what is happening. और Mercury क्या है? यहाँ पे मर्करी का भी अपना डिप्रेशन होगा. एक्चुअली मर्करी इज रिवॉल्विंग इन इट्स डिप्रेशन. द डिप्रेशन इट हैज क्रिएटेड इन द फैब्रिक. साइंस अटैक नहीं हुआ आपकी शक्ल से लग रहा है मुझे. तो साइंस अटैक में ग्रेविटेशन वेव नहीं हुआ? हुआ था ना, ये सब बताया होगा. तो ग्रेविटेशन वेव इज बेसिकली दिस इज वन. दिस मर्करी इज रिवॉल्विंग इन अ डिप्रेशन क्रिएटेड इन द फैब्रिक.